disease or whatever you're doing, fill up your orb, your aura with golden light or whatever your favorite color is. Fill it up with light, confident light, powerful light, warm light, present light. And imagine when you're standing somewhere that you are planting roots into the ground, so you can't be knocked over. You're very powerful and present. And then maybe you're a ballerina or a king or a queen, and you have a crown or a string to the sky, to the heavens. So there's these two opposing forces, and you're taking up a lot of space. So when you walk into a room, you feel a little bit more present and powerful and warm. So those are my recommendations for confident communication and faking it until you make it. The last element is connections. And so you guys are all really, 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 really lucky to be a part of Trek Camp and to meet new people and to meet each other and go to all these amazing places like Cambridge Innovation Center and MIT and all these cool places in Boston. Boston is a great hub. You're all very lucky, and I'm sure you know it. So, connections. I want you to think about informational interviews, asking your mentors and people you really admire and respect, hey, how did you get your business started? Hey, I'm having this problem. Do you think you can help me out? Like, using people as a resource, because ultimately, life is really giving and receiving. Giving and receiving, giving and receiving. Karma, just this flow. That's what life is all about. So don't stop the flow. Don't stop giving. Don't stop receiving. So think of networking as you're in the flow of giving and receiving. So connections that I've made, and they happen all kinds of different ways. They probably happen from your family. You know, in the States we call it nepotism, taking advantage of your father or your mother or your family situation. But let's face it, there are so many people on the planet, you should take advantage of your family situation if you can. Absolutely. Your friends, your family. So my first internship in London, I got through a connection with my father. But then I got a little bit more crafty. I would send cold emails or LinkedIn messages, and this is how I got some other internships. One I found on Craigslist, online, which is pretty dodgy. Others I went to career fairs. And the other is just networking. I met people in something like this, or at a restaurant, or wherever. Just always be open to meeting someone who could help you make that ideal that you imagined a reality. So, this exercise, this final exercise, is writing down three people who you know who can help you design that life that you imagined. At the beginning, like three people that you've been meaning to talk to, you've been meaning to call, you admire them, you respect them, you know they can help you, advise you. Just write down the names of three people. And sometime this week, I want you to call or email one of those people. And remember, it's giving and receiving, giving and receiving. Don't be shy to ask people for a favor. Chances are they probably do want to help you. Final thoughts I want to leave you with, back to us being a baby and then one day we'll die, right, back to that frame of mind, is we're all working really hard to make money. To make money to have a better life and be happy, right? Because money, no? What, tell me about your philosophy if that's not true.
About money? Well, just giving and being. So, touching on some of, I think, oriental philosophy things you mentioned. Bubble and energy, just being yourself and giving to others, and just making an impact, a higher impact, and getting to know your true essence and sharing it with others.
Excellent.
So that's what I'm
doing. So you're plugged into that.
I'm plugged into that. Yeah.
Awesome.
And I do think a lot of people, most people, just want to get money, so I'll let them know that.
Yeah,
that's
good.
That's not the way. I don't think that's the answer.
Yeah.
So of course I agree with what you're saying.
Yeah. I mean, money is not the answer. It's good. It will buy like a cool bracelet. That is an awesome bracelet. It will buy like a cool jacket or a Coca-Cola, and it will help you have pleasurable experiences. Money, people who are millionaires and billionaires, are not necessarily happy. So, and it allows you to detach. And that's actually the number one way that you can be really confident and perform very well in any kind of presentation. You've prepared and you've done really well, but you're actually detached from the outcome. You don't really care if you get that money. You don't really care if they judge you or whatever, because you're so confident and so present and powerful and warm. You don't really need anybody else, because you know what you're doing is your life's work and you're doing your best. So money is important and we want it. It buys nice things. It helps us help other people too. But it can't buy life. And again, life is our limited resource. So that's what I leave you with. And again, the last thing was like the most important thing. Our life is finite. And today is the 5th year anniversary of when I started Holy You. So 5 years ago today, I started Holy You, which is really exciting because they say 80 to 90% of startups never make it to 50 years. God, I don't think I'll make it that long. But 5 years. Because why? Because it's really hard. It's really hard, you know? And people don't make it that long. But, so this is the key. If you really, really, really love it, and you're great at what you do, and you do a good job, and you're making money, and you're in the flow, and you persist, you have that persistence. That's so overused, but that's really it. You just never, ever, 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 ever stop. And you keep going if you know it's the right thing. So, I would love to hear any questions that you might have about this process. I know I threw a lot at you. Hopefully there are some little nuggets. Hopefully you took one nugget that might be helpful to you as you think about how to balance the technical stuff of like being an entrepreneur and finance stuff, but being a human sharing spirit as you do it. So any questions? What are your questions? How to guide your thoughts? So you want to talk more about guiding your thoughts? Yeah, sure. So I suggest, so the question was, how do you guide your life with your thoughts? Now, I could talk about my own personal situation, which I might do. I'll give you some examples. But I can also give you examples of people. Like I said, Louise Hay, she's very, very popular. So Hay, H-A-Y. And she has what's called affirmations. So every day, rather than looking at yourself in the mirror and saying, shit, like you again, like, you know, you're so, you haven't made your goals or your deadlines and being like mean to yourself, she says to have affirmations that like lift you up and like look at yourself in the mirror and like, sounds cheesy, I love you, you're beautiful. You're doing a great job. You're doing your best. You're doing so awesome. You're wonderful. You know, like, and it might sound fake at the beginning, like, but fake it till you make it. So telling yourself really good thoughts every day. So when you're like, oh, I'm so stupid. Actually, I'm really awesome. And it sounds crazy, but just try it. And so on Facebook, is everyone on Facebook?
Yes.
Okay. Like some of us hate Facebook, but we're on it anyway. I hate Facebook. And I've blocked everybody on Facebook. I'm not interested in your dog or your baby or anything. I use it for business, but what I have picture of a cheetah, and it reminds you, oh wow, we're just